Okay, the next what we see will be exercise 3.3, wherein we are going to find out the square root of some numbers by prime factorization method. So it is similar to what we did in the first exercise, but now it is a proper exercise based on prime factorization. So let's go through them one by one, and there are also certain things wherein we are using decimal points. So let's see exercise 3.3, first ka first, that is 784. Now you're going to do prime factorization over here, so this is going to be 784 divided by 2, it will be 392 divided by 2, 196, again 2, that will be 98, again 2, 49, then 7771. So we can see over here this pair and this pair. We need to find out the square root, so we are just saying over here the square root of 748 is the square root of, we are going to write 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 7 into 7. Okay, this will be equal to 2 into 2 into 7, hence the answer is 28. Is it clear? So we can write the answer as root of 784 is 28. Got it? Let's take the next sum, that is sum number 3, which is 1849. Okay, so 9 9 9 18 22, so you cannot divide it by, it is not divisible by 3 because the total is not divisible by 3. If you take it 7, then 7 will be 14, and then 44 is a 2, and then 29 again not divisible. Okay, so here we need to see again. So now normally when such a thing happens, when it is not divisible by 2 3 5 7, then you need not try all the numbers in between, but you need to try the numbers which are prime numbers after that. So as such, it's a prime factorization. So you can see with 11, so if you talk about 11, 11 ones are 11, then 74, so 74 will give me 66, so that will be 8, so again not possible, so 11 it is not going to work. We can try further with be okay, I'll give you one easier solution to this. Okay, yeah, it is getting difficult over here. So what we'll do is that we will try to find out where exactly this particular answer is going to lie. This is a shortcut method. Very important, whenever the number is something like this, which is not divisible by 2, 3, 5, 7, 11 bhi tak nahi hua, 13 ko bhi try karne jayenge to division hi difficult ho jayega. So, isiliye what we do is we try an approximate value. Now, what is the nearest value you know, which is the square of this square, which is the nearest number? So, I know one thing, that 40 ka square is 1600. Right, 40 ka square is 1600, and 45 ka square kya hai? You know it is 25, and 4 into 5 is 20, so 2025. So that means if this is a square number, it has to lie between this and this. Are we clear? 40 ka square is 1600. 45 ka square, I know by the trick of 5 numbers ending with 5 is 25, and 5 4s are 20, so 2025. This number is lying between the two. Yane, ye ya to 41, 42, 43 or 44. Ye charo mein se kisi ek ka hi ye square number hai. Now let us see the last digit. Last digit is 9. If it is last digit is 9, that means it is a odd number. So the number which has to be in between has to be an odd number. because odd number ka square jo hai wo odd number ho sakta hai. So what we are having, see, so it was 41, 42, 43 and 44. These were the options. The moment I say this is an odd number, so automatically they odd numbers hi rahenge aur ye cancel ho jayega. So only possibility is this and this. इसका स्क्वायर जब भी रहेगा तो वन का स्क्वायर क्या होता है, वन होता है. सो दिस इज नाइन, सो नॉट पॉसिबल. इसका स्क्वायर नाइन हो सकता है, दैट्स व्हाई दिस विल गेट इरेज एंड आंसर ओवर हियर विल बी 1849 विल बी 43. व्हेन आई डिवाइड दिस थिंग आई एम गोइंग टू गेट 43. सो 43 एंड 1, वी कैन ट्राई दिस थिंग, वी कैन सी दिस 43 इंटू 43. 3 3s आर 9, 3 4s आर 12, 0, 4, 3 are 12, 4, 16, 17, so 9, 4, 8, 1, exactly the same. Understood? Such sums normally become very difficult because hum log chalu karenge 11 se, 13 se, 17, 19, 23, all the prime factors, prime numbers, if you try dividing this big number, it is going to be very, very time consuming and you will never come to the particular answer. Moreover, this will be hardly for 3 marks. Maximum 3 marks. Abhi 3 mark ke liye, agar hum log itna bada jhanjhat karenge, it is not worth it. So, we need to find out such kind of methods so that it is easier for us to find out the answer. Got it? So, the answer becomes... So, the square root of 1849 is 43. See, this problem comes up only when it is a square of a prime number. 43 is a prime number. That's the problem over here. Okay? Sure. Let's see the next one. You see the first ka... fifth sum, the fifth sum over here is 6241. 6241. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 hai, 3 se divide nahi hoga. You can try with 7. So it is 6241. If I divide by 7, then again 8 za, then 64, 63, 1, 11 nahi hoga. 11 se try karke dekh lete hai, baki na to chhod denge. 55. 55 kiya to it will be 74, 66 again not possible. So again we will use the same trick. What do we have now? 6,3249, 6,000. I know that 80, so 64, just see, mujhe kaun sa number lena hai? This is 64, 62. So the nearest square number is 64. So the nearest number is 6400, which is of 80. The bigger number will be 6400. The smaller number will take it as 75. So 75 will be how much? 525. 7 8s are 56. So it is 5625. Now, what are the options? 76, 77, 78, and 79. It is a odd number. So 76 and 78 nikal gaya. 9 ka end 1 hota hai, 7 ka 9 hota hai, yani ye nikal gaya, answer kya milega? 79. Just put 79 here, 79 here, 79 here and 1. That's the square root of 6241 is 79. If you are slightly doubtful about the answer, best thing, calculate again. 9 9s are 81, 9 63, 63 plus 8 is 71, 0. 9 7 is 63, so 6, 7 is 49 plus 6 is 55. So that gives me 1, 4, that is 12 and 6. 6241, 6241, correct. Hence, this is my answer. Got it? This makes it simpler for you to do these sums, right? So that was 6241 ka square root is 79. We could go to the next sum now. That is sum number 7. Sum number 7. It is 8281. Same problem again. 8, 10 and 9, 19. Not divisible by 3, not divisible by 9. 7 se divide karenge to bhi chances kami hai. So what do we see? Again the same thing. We see the two numbers over here. What is 82? 82 का नियर स्क्वायर नंबर क्या है? 81. व्हाट इज 81 फॉर 90. सो इट इज 90 का स्क्वायर इज 8100. This is more than that, so we'll take 95 as the next number, which will be 25. 9 into 10 will be 90, so 9025. So what is the possibility? It could be 91, 92, 93 and 94. It is odd or even odd. So even numbers vanish. Now ending with 1, 3 ka end 9 se hota hai. Ye 1 hai, yani kya hoga? It will be 8, 2, 9, 91, 91, 91, 1. Cross check. So it will be 91 into 91, 1, 1 and 9, 0, 9, 8, 1. So 1, 8, 2. So it is 8, 2 and 8. Therefore root of 8, 2, 8, 1 is equals to 91. Are we clear with this? Right? So all these sums were of this typical nature, wherein they were much more the answers for all the prime numbers of the number system. Okay? In such cases, trying to do the prime factorization becomes very difficult. So this is the best method to apply. You can try solving the alternate sums and see whether you understood this thing properly or not. Okay? We go to the next question, question number 2. Okay, in question number 2, they are given as mixed fractions. So, question 2 first is 967 upon 121. So now it is nothing but 121 into 9, that is 9, 18 and then 10 plus 67, that will be 6, 5, 15, 1, 1. 1, 1, 5, 6. Okay. Clear? 9, 9, 18. So it is going to be 1, 1, 5, 6 upon 121. We need to find out the square root of this. So this is what we need to find out the square root for. So now what we are going to do is do the prime factorization. You already know that 121 is a square of 11. So you need not write over here. You can directly, okay, I need to remove this. This is nothing but square root of, this is 11 into 11. Now let's do the prime factorization of 1156. You have a 2, it will be 5, 7, 8, 2, so 2, 8, 9, then again 3, so 3, 9, 20, 97. Okay, 1 second, 2, 4, 16. Yeah, so 289. Now 289 is yeah, I think it is 7, 0, 7. The foot, so these are 21, 79, 19, 11. You can just find this out. So again, we are landing up to the same thing over here. 289. If you see, it is a square of 17. So it is just 17 into 17 is 289. Again, if you want, you can check it out this way. At 28, the nearest square number you need to find out involve that 15 is 225, 20 is 400. So 16, 17, 18, yes, 9 kis mein aega? Only in 17. So it is 17. So this is going to be 2 into 2 into 17 into 17, that makes it 17 upon 11, sorry, 17 into 2, that is 34 upon 11, which is nothing but 3, 1 upon 11 is the answer. Okay, the answer of this is 3, 1 upon 11. Okay, we see the next sum, third sum, 1.96. Now again, here, what we are going to do is that we will convert this into a fraction, that is 196 upon 100. We are just multiplying this numerator and denominator by 100, so it becomes 196, and this becomes 196 upon 100. Now, you know very well that the square root, so we want to find out the square root of 196 upon 100. We know that it is nothing but over here, this is nothing but 2 into 2 into 5 into 5, because this is 100, you know it is a 10 square. So even if you don't write this much, it doesn't matter. But anyway, prime factor should come out to be that way. And 196 ka ye aayega 196. So it's actually 14 ka square, but you can do it over here. So it is 2. So it will be 9's are 18, and then 8, and then 2, and then 49, and then 7, 7, 7, 1. So it will be 2 into 2 into 7 into 7. That brings it to 14 upon 10. Hence, answer is 1.4. The square root of 1.96 is 1.4. Do you understand this? Okay, so that was about the second sum. I think I'll stop here because the questions over here, hold on just a minute. We'll continue with one more question. For each of the following numbers, find the smallest number by which it should be multiplied so that it is a perfect square. Also find the square root of the number to be obtained. So the same thing again, as I told you earlier, whatever we are not in pairs, whichever numbers are not in pairs will be the one which has to be multiplied. So we see this one is question number 3. Question number 3, the first one is given as 588. So you do the prime factorization here. Do not use that method of trial because this is not a perfect square. So remember that this is not a perfect square. It's 588. Dividing by 2, we get it as 2, 9 and 4. Then 2, that's 1, 4, 7. Then this will be divided by 3. So 3, 4 is 12 and 27 will be 9. So 7, 7, 7, 1. You can see this and these are in pair, but this is not in pair. So the number to be multiplied, so it is 2 into 2 into 3 into 7 into 7. Therefore, number to be multiplied is equals to 3. Now, they also told us that also find the square root of the number so obtained. So, what is the square root? So, if I multiply this by 3, now this also becomes a pair. So, this is a pair, this is a pair, and this is a pair. So, the square root will be 2 into 3 into 7. So, that is 21 into 2 is 42. So, the number, once it is multiplied by 3, the square root will be 42. So, the question was also find the square root. So, square root obtained is equals to 42. Okay, next sum, sum number 3. 2178. 2178. Same way. 2178. Divided by 2. 10. That will be 8 and then 9. So this would be 3's are, 3 3's are, then 18 will be 6, and then 3 again, right? Then again 3, it's 1, 2, 1, 11, 11, 11, 1, okay? So that gives me that this is nothing but, this is a pair, this is a pair. So it's equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 11 into 11. Therefore, number to be multiplied is equals to 2, and square root will be equal to 2 into 3 into 11, that is 66. Understood? Because when I multiply this by 2, then I get this is a pair, this is a pair, and this is a pair. So it's 2 into 3 into 11, which is 66. You go to the next one, which is sum number 5 of the third part. That's the sum is 6300. 6300. 6300. Divided by 2, it will give me 3150. Again, divided by 2, 1575. Divided by 3, this will give me 525. Again, by 3, so it will be 1, then 217, and 115 will be 5. So 13 to 5, that will be 5, 3s are 15, and 25 will be 5, then 5 will be 7, 7 and 1. So you can see, this is a pair, this is a pair, this is a pair, and 7 is alone. So you get it as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 7. Therefore multiplied, answer to be multiplied will be into 7. So you can say number to be multiplied is equals to 7, and the square root will be equal to 2 into 3 into 5 into 7. That is going to be further 10 and 21, so 210. Okay, so that is 210 will be the answer if you multiply it by 7. Are we clear? So that was question number 3. Now we move on to question number 4. Question 4 is exactly identical again. Only thing is that instead of multiplication, they are asked us to divide. So they are asking us that what is the number to be divided? So find the smallest number by which it should be divided so that the quotient is a perfect square. Also find the square root. So exactly the same way, we are going to do the same way. The fourth ka first. The number is 1872. You prime factorize it, you get it as 1872 divided by 2 is 9. 3, 4, again 2 will be 4, then 6 and 7. This will be divided by 3, 9, 7, 42, 9. So that makes 7, 11 was 44, 9, 7, 20, 47. No, let's see. Okay, I think there's a mistake over here. This is not 4, this should be 6. So it's 1, yeah, it is 9. Ah, yeah, 6, sorry. So this is going to be again 2, so that will give me 4, and then 6, and then 8. Then again 2, that will be 2, 3, 4, then 2, then 1, and then 1 and 7, 1, 1, 7, this will be again divided by 3, this will give me 3, 3s are 9, and then 27, so it will be 9, that will be 3 again, so it's 13, and 13, and 1, okay, so, sorry, 13, So, it's, you can see over here, or did I make a mistake? 39, so 13, 31, yeah, fine. So, you can see that this is nothing but 2 into 2, 1, 2, yeah, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now, 2 into 2 into 3 into 13. So now you can see this is in a pair, this is in a pair, but this all these three numbers are not in a pair. So the number to be divided will be 13 into 3, 39, 39 into 2 will be 78. So the number to be divided is equal to 2 into 3 into 13 is equal to 78. And the square root will be jiska pair already hai. The pair will be 4. So that gives me the answer for 3.3 ka fourth. This to be divided by 3.3 exercise 5. Okay, I think I made a mistake. Let me check. Let's start from here. So this is 1, again 1 and 7. Now this I know it is divisible by 3. 3 3s are 9. Yeah, 3 3s are 9 and then then again it will be 3, then it will be 13, and then it will be 13, and then it will be 1. So yeah, I missed out over here. It's 2 into 2 into 2 into 4 into this is 3. Yeah, that was the problem. I wrote over here 2. So your only thing which is going to be alone is 13. This is alone. So number to be divided is equals to 13. And the square root is equals to, now the numbers which are already in pairs, it is 2 into 2 into 3. So it is equals to 12. That's the answer for fourth ka first. The next one will be the third question. That is 3 8 0 0 2 1 6 9 0 2 8 45 okay, then again 9 and 8 17 okay, so 5s are, so 5 1s are, then 34 is 6 and 45 9s are. 169 is a square number of 13, so 13 13s are 169. So that's the thing, that it is going to be, so that makes it this a pair, this is the one which is alone. So it is 2 into 2 into 5 into 13 into 13. Therefore number to be divided is equals to 5, and the square root is equals to 2 into 13 is equals to 26. That's the answer. Because iska square ye aur ye, the square root will be of 2 into 2 and 13 in 13 into 13, so that will be 26. Okay. This is 36. Right, we come to the next question, that is question number 4 ka 5. I think this will be the last for this particular video. So that is fifth one is 6 1 3 4 7. Okay, we have got over here 6 1 3 4 7, 10 20 21, so divisible by 3, so it is 2 0 4 4 and 27, so 9. So again divisible by 3. 3 6 is 18, 24 is 8, and 1 or nahi ho raha. Okay, so it is 1 3 4 7 divided by 10. We have to do it again. Okay, now this is a very tricky sum, because over here I cannot find out any particular factor over here. So we will need to use that method what we had used earlier for finding out the square numbers. So what I can see is 204. Now I know that 14 is 196. So automatically 140 will be 19600. So it will be 140 is 19600, which is greater than this. And 145 will be 25 and 14 into 15. 15 into 14 will be 210. So it is between these two. Again, the same thing. 1 will not be there. 2 and 4 will not be there. So it will be only 143. So 143, 143, 143 and 1. Very, very important. You may go on trying, but you will not find it. Hence, this method is the best solution. So you can see over here, this is nothing but 3 into 143 into 143. Hence, the number to be divided is equals to 3, because 3 is the only number which is alone. And square root will be equal to 143. Understood? So now what you can do is that you can take the question number 1, 2, 3 and 4 ka alternate sums which are not done as your homework, and let me know if you have got any doubts in those questions. Only after that we'll start with the next part of the exercise. Meanwhile, I will like to, I'll just find out also that what are the things we are done in school, or basically given from the school to be done. Okay.